everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Jurassic World Alive, where before we start, if you go to the link in the description below, you can get yourself 50 bucks for free. All you need to do is open or click on that link on the device that you have Jurassic World Alive installed. It will take you to, it should open the game for you, and then you'll get 50 free bucks. It's what I do. I've been using my own links. But today, I'm coming at you with something straight off the press. Straight off today, I'm recording. And I want to get out now just because I've been playing the tournament. And I've been having like some really good luck, you'll see. But I'm really enjoying it and I just wanted to make a video. And also, I can't forget you guys. You need that 50 bucks as much as I do. But before we get into all of that, Titanoboa has now been released and some lucky people have managed to find it in the global spawns. So, just like stuff like Cinoceratops, Titanoboa is also a creature that you can bump into the wild. Hence, we have a whole snake pit. The snake pit. So we just need to click that one more time, maybe two more times. Is that four? That'll take us to four. Oh, okay. We need to play with one more. And there we have it. We have our own Titanoboa unlocked. And look at this. Look at these animations. Isn't it gorgeous? So now people will start to get the whatchamacallit, the Dilophoboa. And then after that, it'll be the next one, the Serpent something or other. That one. So I'm just going to quickly unlock my own Titanoboa. And I should hopefully have an extra... hopefully I've got some space in my sanctuary. So there we go. Dilophoboa created. Oh, sorry. Titanoboa. I'm getting ahead of myself. Titanoboa created. So we need to get up to level 15 as well. So 2,100. 577. So what's unique about this guy? I know it's the swap thing. So decelerating impact. Immune to distraction, which is good. And on escape rampage. So when the opponent leaves, you do 2x attack. I mean... that's amazing. So that means impact and run, rampage and run, any move like that where it allows the opponent to switch. Yeah, if Titanoboa's in there, you're not going to want to do that. Or just even switching in. Let's say your dinosaur's about to die, it's done. Because even if you switch it, it's taking a 2x hit. But it is just 2x. It's not like armor piercing or anything. So if you do have something with high armor, you're probably okay. So let's just go. Oh, this is the other one. That's the other one. The Spino Constrictor. Spinosaurus level 20. Well, I got a level 10 and I got about 30,000 DNA. So I think I'm okay. I think I'm going to have that. But I'm going to need a lot more Spinosaurus. Spinosaurus is one of those creatures that I bump into quite often. So hopefully I can put one in. Yes, there we go. Okay, now whereabouts will it be? It'll probably be around the bottom because it's level 11. There it is. Boom! Added to the snake pit. Now, I'm not too sure exactly how much DNA, because when you get your creature back, sometimes you get more DNA, sometimes you get less DNA. I wonder if it's depending on how many people have interacted on your creature. Ludio, if you're listening, that would be really cool, because then it incentivizes people to work together. It's like, okay, guys, we're going to make a snake pit. Everybody use all your food and play resources on these snakes, and then we'll get even more, and then we'll have the next hybrid. That's what it should be. But hey, I'm just a lowly old YouTuber who nobody listens to. So I hope you guys have your cup of tea. I'm not too happy with this one. It's nice. It's a cup of tea, but it is it has no sugar in. That it is like drinking warm water. But you're here. I may as well do it while you're here. 5,000 coin. Meh. Even more meh. All right, meh. And yeah, we need that now. Spinosaurus. I mean, not for a long time, but. Campaign as well is something, but the tournament, which ends in 22 hours, I am rank 347. Because last night at about 2 o'clock, I decided, you know what, it doesn't cost to enter. Let's give this a shot. I saw somebody on the Facebook group for Jurassic World Alive. They showed their teams, like, is this a good team? I thought, you know what, the problem with these tournaments is that I don't know what to use. So, and with the whole list of dinosaurs you can use, sometimes you're like, ah, Jesus. But I start with this and I've swapped things in, swapped things out, and everything on this team has a purpose. Everything. Well, except for the Brachiosaur and the Titanoboa, really. I mean, they just kind of work whatever. I've seen loads of different types of strategies come out for this. And I've been quite impressed with what people have came up with. But we're going to jump in here because I was on the 250 players. If I win one more, I'll be there. So I got 250,000 gold. At the moment, we're on 100,000. The strategy here is turtle. Carbonymous is like everybody has one because it's really good. And you'll see why. Oh God, I didn't turn the volume off. Okay, well, we'll just put in our own music. We'll get some Pokemon on the go. So actually, we don't have Carbonymous this time, but we have a Carbonymous counter, Carbonymous. So I'm gonna start with the Mammoth. It's a solid counter, kind of, but not really. It can hold its own against it. Postosuchus. Oh, that's interesting. Ooh, I like it. So, ooh, that's really good. Yeah, he's got... Oh, really not Ferocious Strike? I would have went for that straight away. Unless he goes for Adrenaline Pulse. I don't know what Adrenaline Pulse does. Priority Cleanse and Regenerate 25%. Okay, so he should have went for Ferocious Impact and then went for Defense Shattering. That's what I would have done. So I'm just going to go for my regular hit. Mammoth, really good. Really strong creature. Oh, God, he would have killed me, see? He would have killed me if he switched those moves around. That was not so good. For a player that's maybe high ranked like me, not a great stop. My sword, it's going to be faster. Okay, so it's probably going to die. And you know what? I'm just going to take that. I'm going to take that loss. That's fine. Okay, so Myosaurus, what does it have going for it? It's impact and run, basically. It's instant rampage and impact and run. So that's 2x damage. I'm going to go for my sneaky snake. Because this guy doesn't allow swapping. And if the opponent does swap, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go for my shielding, because he's probably going to go for instant rampage, I would assume. I'm going to make sure I go first next time, and then I'll kill him. Actually, I say that, I don't think I am going to kill him. So his decrease in speed. This isn't good, because I don't have the turtle. And he might have a turtle. So I'm trying to click on my snake. How do I look at my snake stats? There we go. Okay, so I'll do 2,200. And his attack is reduced for 2 turns. So that's okay. I'm okay with that. I'll take that. And then the next turn, I'll just go for regular one. Oh, he lowered mine. Ah, well done. Well done. Okay. Ooh. Ooh. Ooh, this is interesting. This is interesting. So he's killed me here because he's probably going to go impact and run. There we go. Okay. Right, right. Oh, this is... Oh, yes, yes. Okay, this is what we wanted. The perfect counter for Carbonymous is Ophicodon. Most people do not expect this to come in. And when it does, oh, it gives them a bit of a shock. So it doesn't matter what he does, he's dead in 2 turns. He knows it. He's like, oh, no. if he's faced off against an Ophicodon. So already, Defense Shattering goes through armor. The reason Carbonymous is such a pain in the backside is because it... And you know what I'm going to do? He's going to go for... If I do that and I do that, that'll kill him, but then he'll shield it. So I'm expecting him to shield here. His speed's 104, mine's 107. I'm going to go for... Yeah, I thought he'd go for that. I thought he would. Dig in. So we'll just get rid of the shield and we'll just crunch him. So he's dead in 3 turns. Not so good. If I had my Carbonymous, it would be better, but I don't. So now we're just going to go for the regular hit, the big one. I think I can kill his Myosaurus in one hit as well, so it depends what his other creature is, really. If it's not good enough, it might die here. He might lose. This is a tight matchup because I didn't have my turtle. The thing is, you want... Oh, it's Allosaurus! Oh, no! Oh, no! I've lost. Well, GG. That was well played. I got very unlucky with my lineup there. I'm okay. I'll take that loss. That was good. I would normally say well played, but because this is an iPad, and if I prod it too hard, it might lose connection. So I'll not say that. So there we go. We lost one match. It was last night at about 2 o'clock. Oh, was it 1 o'clock? 1 o'clock in the morning. I thought, yeah, let's try the tournament. 10 wins in a row later, it's 4 o'clock in the morning. And I'm like, oh. Because I was doing so well. I was like, oh my God, I'm getting so much more gold. Titanoboa, like a Brachiosaur would have been better than Titanoboa there. A Brachiosaur would have been better. I saw somebody who had a whole team that was comprised around Velociraptor. So he sent in his Velociraptor first, and if it wasn't a good matchup for his Velociraptor, he would switch it out for, okay, a Sinoceratops, which would come in and do a stun and a hit, or a Mayasaurus, which would do a stun as soon as it comes in, or a Tyrannosaurus, which would come in and do a stun. It was literally like, whatever died, he switched his raptor, still not a good matchup, or he could do a pounce, then he'd switch out to a Mayasaurus or something. I managed to beat that just with the Carbonemus. That's horrendous. I've lost this. I don't like that at all. Should we start with Overcodon? Yeah, why? Oh, is it risky to start with Overcodon? Let's start with Miagaia. This is another counter for the Carbonemus. Interesting. Interesting. Not too bad on a matchup here. Not too bad. I'm going to take a big hit, but at least it doesn't get a crit. Because if you got a crit, he would have killed me there. So, I tell you what, we got the crit. And do I kill him? Okay, I don't kill him. This is okay, because it allows me to set up for something else. There is no point me healing here. No point whatsoever. Because, yeah, a rendering takedown, which does 0.6 of your health. Over half! And I would have barely just got that back. And I'd rather be in a position to set something up. So, I want to save my Overcodon just in case. But I'll get a shield up. I think that's how it works. I think the shield might only last for one turn, though. It might only last for one turn. But he can't switch, so at least we've guaranteed a kill. He might try and switch, not expecting it, because a lot of people don't expect that to come from Titanoboa. Although now I have Titanoboa, not Gen 2, I wonder if it's worth using that one. Because having a Rampage might be better. Like, doing a Rampage if they switch out, than just stunning them. Ooh, a bleeder. Interesting. Okay. What do we go for, guys? What's he got? He's got a rampage, which is 2,200. Here comes the lethal wound. I thought as much. So we're going to do two hits. This is not good, man. Two matches where I didn't get my my turtle. Or Mammoth's really good, just... If I have that turtle, I feel much safer. So we'll go for a rampage. It won't kill him, but whatever comes in next will be quicker. And then it's not going to be Sarcosuchus. Sarcosuchus is good to switch in. And then unless they've got immunity, they can't switch out. So there we go. Marsupial Lion as well is another really good one. And I didn't get that. You're going to watch me go from rank 300 to rank bottom. So Overcodon, so if he does have a turtle, now he's worried if he does have a turtle, and he's relying on that to like sweep at the end. There's been a few matches I've had where Carbonemus has, interesting, but I wonder why he's done that. It depends what his other creature is. He's got one more still in the wings, so we can do that. He might go for a dig in here. It's possible he might go for a dig in. So if he does, he'll probably go for a dig in. I would assume he's expecting me to go for that big hit and kill him in one, and he's not going to like that, so he's probably going to go for a dig in. Oh, he didn't! Damn it! Okay. Could be worse. Instant charge. Okay. Interesting. I can possibly still kill the turtle, though, with this health. I can definitely kill his Spinosaurus. But it depends what his other... It's the turtle! It's always the flipping turtle! Always. Right. Okay, so... He can go for Vulnerable Strike. He'll probably go for Dig-In. I think he's going to go for Dig-In. Oh, he didn't go for Dig-In! Oh, the crit! Ooh, it's gonna be close. Oh, man. I could have killed him if I'd went for my first one. Damn, I could have won. If I was him, I would have went for Dig In just so I'd have got the speed advantage over him. But, hey-ho, what are you gonna do? So there it is, 1,400. Now, unfortunately, we've lost here because Sarcosuchus can't do anything. Unless, okay, let's see. There might be like a slim chance. Yeah, vulnerability. I have no armor, so I'm going to take a big hit from this devastating attack that's coming. And I can't bleed him out, which is a shame. That devastation's going to do a lot of damage, and I'm dead. Well played. That was good. Again, didn't get my turtle. Faced against people that did have the turtle. And, it didn't end out too well for me. Probably should switch in Titanoboa. Oh, I did really well last night. Let's make a video. Oh, god damn it. But I do have marsupial lion. That's an instant, like, two or three hits, and he's dead. And he can't. I'm immune. Marsupial lion's immune, so. Oh, what's good here? And kind of, let's just make sure that whatever he puts in first can't switch out. It might be the turtle, though. Oh, for God's sake! Really? Really? Out of everything you could have put, another turtle! That's okay, but we probably lost Sarko here. I'm okay losing Sarko. Because he gets like 1,000 health. So it depends what he does here. He could go for devastation and then just kill me. In fact, he's probably going to do that. So because he's going to do that, I'm going to go for... I don't want to say goodbye to Sarcosuchus. That's the problem. Oh, damn. Oh, he went for it again. Interesting. Did he expect me to switch out? He might have. Okay, so... we're going to go for a bellow just to make sure that we can get his health down. His speed down. He might go for dig in here. Oh, no, he didn't. Oh, okay. Well, it's halved anyway, whatever he did. He's still slower. What's our... oh, okay. Never mind. No, oh, we're faster. Okay, so we could do a rampage. But it's not very good, though, is it? It's not very good. I might as well. Yeah, I've just got to do this. I've just got to slowly chip at him. Again, the thing is, this whole tournament is based around Carbonemus. And unfortunately, if I put a marsupial lion out first, he would have been done. Okay, so now we're in a good stead. We can just kill him in probably two hits here. But he might switch out. Marsupial lion has won more battles like this, so it's possible he might win. We'll see. He's worried now. He's actually worried. He's dead in two hits either way. So even if he does dig in, he's not going to be quicker than me because his speed's pretty slow. And he's dead because... yep, there you go. He's dead. Nothing you can do. Marsupial lion, I've only ever seen one person play it, is a killer for the turtle. Turtle didn't do any damage to me and it's dead. And a lot of people... I've never seen people play marsupial lion. So... if you're watching, put it in your team if you want some coin. So this is a good... I've seen a lot of people start with Woolly Mammoth against Carbo. So what does he have? Does he have a speed decrease? He does have a speed decrease. But I'm immune. So I'm just going to go for the two hits and kill him. Lethal wound. I'm immune to it. So... oh, wait, no. I'm immune to... oh, oops. Whoopsies! I'm immune to deceleration. I forgot about that. Okay, does he have an instant charge? He doesn't have an instant charge. Okay, just gonna go for the big hit there. Kill him. Oh, he's alive! Oh, this actually might not be too bad. I've killed his turtle, and it depends what he does here. What do I have again? Do I have anything good, like a mammoth or something? I have a Titanoboa, but... Titanoboa's not too... it's not too great. Like, if this was Mastodon, I'd say the match is won. Because I would get my increased attack and then something else. I've just been getting really unlucky with these. There's a chance that he might switch out, so I'll just go for a hit. Yeah, just go for a hit. Now, it depends what he's got. If it's got a lot of armor, I'm done. I might be done. Myasaura would be a good one to kill me. Secodontosaurus. Interesting. Is quicker, but he's also immune. Ah. And that's where he's going to get this victory. He's going to pull this win out of the fact that, yeah, critical impact. And Good, 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 good. Again, another match did have a damn turtle, and they all did. So I've lost. Oh, dear. Yeah, there it is. There it is. Good game. Well played. That is horrendous. Like, I would have switched out. Let's have a look. Let's change my team. Let's switch out Titanoboa Gen 2 for... Oh, I can't because it's in the sanctuary. Damn it. Oh, no. Oops. I'm going to switch it in for Allosaurus. I'm going to switch in for Allosaurus Gen 2 because Allosaurus Gen 2 is a good counter for the turtle. And the turtle is always there. So, here we go. And if you put Allosaurus out first, you're probably going to do a lot of damage. So again, no flipping turtle, but Marsupialion's there. Marsupialion is a turtle counter. So with that in mind, Woolly Mammoth is probably going to be something to finish off and then get a big rampage on the next one. So it could be Brachiosaurus or Allosaurus, but I'll go for Allosaurus here. Oh, T-Rex. Interesting. Unfortunately, I'm just a tad bit faster. Unless he gets a crit. Ooh, I don't even know. Is Allosaurus Gen 2 better? 30% crit chance. T-Rex is 30% crit chance. And they're around about the same. So I'm just going to go for this. I might as well just take a rendering takedown in case he switched. So if the turtle comes in, turtle's going to take a big hit. So he's not going to put in the turtle if he has it, which leaves him with two other creatures. I'm just going to say that they probably got the turtle. Ooh, Erlikosaurus. He's probably going to go for a rampage here. Now that's good because, is it though? Is it? I'll let him do his rampage. Get that out of his system. Get the victory there. Pull that victory out. Okay. Something that's good against it, probably Brachiosaurus, just to do, a big hit because he's got no armor and to slow him down. So we can go for a superiority strike. Ah, he's getting out of there. This might be the turtle. What is that? Turtle? Oh, Kentrosaurus. Ooh, interesting. Interesting. Okay. Right. So he's got Erlikosaurus and Kentrosaurus and a mystery dinosaur left. Medium attack. Okay. Now, what do we do? What do we do? Because everything else... I mean, how much armor does the Woolly Mammoth have? 10% armor. I might as well just go for regular. Oh, instant destruction. I don't know why. I'm going to kill you in two hits, mate. It doesn't matter what I do here. Oh, I'm not. It's not a guaranteed. Okay. We'll go for... What should we do here? We'll go for rampage. We'll just go for it. Hopefully we get lucky and get a crit. Didn't get the crit. That's okay. And then I'm expecting him... What's he going to do? What does he have? Thagomizer to slow me? Oh, very good. Okay, this is good because it's going to put me in a situation where I can use my mammoth. So I'm just going to fodder off Brachiosaurus. In some cases, it's better to lose your dinosaur first so that if you, like, you can set up with something else. So we're going to use the mammoth who's... Oh, it's not quicker. Oh, dear. Oh, never mind then. Oh, this might not be good, but we do have Bellow. So if he does go for Rampage, we can go for a Bellow. So I'm just going to go for this. He's probably going to go for Thagomize. Oh, no, he'll go for Superiority Strike, yeah. Right. I wouldn't be surprised if he brings in... if he brings in a Erlikosaurus, we've won. So it needs to be the Mystery Dinosaur. What was his other dinosaur? What was it? Was it a turtle? Was it a flipping another turtle? Come on, what was it? Oh, a woolly rhino. Interesting. Okay. Well, we can almost kill him in one hit. So, ooh, decelerating. Interesting. Right. Huh. Okay. Now, he does have the bleed. If I was him, I probably went for the bleed. Unless I'm immune to it, and I don't realize it. I am immune to it. Okay. So then he's probably going to go for definite rampage, going for 2x damage. I'm going to switch to Marsupialion, because otherwise I'm dead, which I don't want to be. And we're in good stead here. We're in good stead. I think unless he gets a crit, and even if he does get a crit, yeah, we've won. It just depends. Oh, lucky. Because, yeah, he's done. His Erlikosaurus has taken a big hit. He might switch, though. He might switch. Oh, has his Erlikosaurus taken a hit? It might not have, actually. No, it hasn't. Oh, it hasn't. Ooh, ooh, he's faster as well. It's going to come down to the wire. It's coming down to the wire. Ooh, ooh, it's... Oh, man, I thought... Why was I so confident? Oh, if I just hurt his Erlikosaurus. Damn. So we've got a 66% chance to dodge this. And we didn't. Four losses in a row. Oh, my God. This is horrendous. But we got to end on a high. Let's see if I can get a turtle on my team so I can show, like, how I use it, which is pretty much... Why? We're deliberately doing this now. Oh, my God. What are the chances? That's ridiculous. I mean, we've got the turtle killers, but... Oh, yep, that's not a good matchup for him. That is not a good matchup. He might even switch out straight away. If he switches out... Oh, he didn't. He didn't. Oh, that's going to hurt him. That's going to hurt his morale, that one. Oh, dear. So he's probably going to kill my Allosaurus, which I'm okay with. Because then Ophicodon, Marsupialion can come in and just kill him. So he'll go... Actually, he can't. He can't. Yeah, he's just going to swap. Well, I'm going to cleanse myself because I'm not having that. And I don't think I'm quicker. Let's just go for a big hit. He's probably going to go for superiority strike here. Oh, Thag. Forgot about that. Thag. Okay. I'm feeling confident. Feeling confident about this. That's two out of his creatures that are gone. His turtle's gone. If he switches in his turtle, that was not a good idea. That was not a good idea. Should we just kill it? We'll kill his turtle. I'll switch in Marsupialion. Because he's going to go for a vulnerability strike. Because he's going to expect that I'm not going to switch. There it is. I am, unfortunately for him, immune to the thingy. The, whatchamacallit, the speed decrease. So I go for this and he's dead. Now he might switch, because he's trying! He's trying his best to save his damn turtle! Makes me think, yeah. I mean, if you've got lucky enough to have the turtle, your chances of winning have probably increased 50%, like. But, it depends what he's got now. What do you have? What do you have that's quicker? It has to be quicker, something like Raptor or... a Raptor could kill me in one hit. Here we go for the pounce. Erlikosaurus could go for a rampage. Woolly Mammoth? I don't think it's faster. No. This is not so good for him. He could go for a bellow, decreasing my speed, but that wouldn't work. Okay. He's saying he's lost, in other words, because he can't decrease my speed, and I go straight through. Yeah. I think he's... Yeah, that's it. So, there we go. So, we lost four games in a row, but with this one... we didn't do too bad. I think we still haven't killed him, actually. Yeah, but he's going to hit me and then I'm going to counter it back. Ooh, I must have just survived this. How much? Ooh, I did. Okay, there you go. So, you know what? For four losses in a row, for a 3-0 victory, I'll take it. And that is against the turtle as well. And the turtle is super hard, so I'm going to keep on going. By the time we do the next video, which will probably be next week, I'll tell you how I did. Like, oh yeah, I had 30 cups, or I don't know. I think I'm on kind of a hot streak with it at the moment. So, but after this video goes out, maybe a lot of people will add Marsupialion to their team because he's just so good. I mean, chances are it's 40% chance of getting a crit, right? And then you have your counterattack and you have your normal attacks. You get a crit on any single one of those and you kill them in two turns. So it's a really high chance. So I'm going to leave it there. We're back to 50,000, but I'm going to continue to do this in my spare time. Good luck to everybody else. Don't forget, link in the description below to grab your 50 bucks. I am also going to be looking for new recruits for the Alliance because I'm way more active in this game recently because I just really love it. I found this tournament, even though it's infuriating at times, I'm enjoying it more than the regular battles with Thordor and Dentus Maxima, all that jazz. I'm enjoying this more because it feels fair. I don't lose because somebody's modded or boosted their dinosaur to hell. I feel like if I lose here, it was a tight matchup. Something wasn't played right. Something that I can fix. Something I'm like, okay, how can I change my strategy? If I lose to modded, boosted creatures, I think nothing I could do there. Because they've just got boosts, and unless they want to pay money, which, you know, no game should be like that, I'm going to lose. This is way better. I like this way better. But yeah, anyway, guys, enjoy this video. Leave a like until next time. I'll see you later. Oh, bye-bye.